Welcome to the University of the Pacific Conservatory's virtual choir concert. My name is Yeji Che, and I am the director of choirs at this wonderful institution. Well, before we start our show tonight, I would like to make a brief acknowledgement on our students' hard work. Well, despite the innate challenges of online instruction, it was a sheer joy for me to witness the extraordinary measure of commitment and dedication in every single one of our students. A special thanks to our video and sound team, Lily Tumbale, Riley Brereton, and Dion Nicholson for everything that they did for tonight's event. Well, as much as we enjoyed the preparation process, I hope that you enjoy our performance. And I do hope that in a very near future that we may see each other in our live concert halls on our beautiful Pacific campus. Thank you very much.
Hello, my name is Michael Atwood. And for our first selection, Pacific Singers presents Lay a Garland by English composer Robert Pearsall. A popular English poem, the text represents a heartbroken woman who is parted from her betrothed. Please enjoy our rendition of the madrigal, Lay a Garland.
Hello, my name is Mara Baldwin. Our next piece is brought to you by four members of the Pacific Singers Ensemble. The group will be performing Daryl Runswick's arrangement of the popular song Blackbird by John Lennon and Paul McCartney. According to McCartney, the song was meant to spread hope, faith, and perseverance in the midst of the racial strife in America in the 1960s. The Blackbird symbolizes the civil rights movement that was fighting for racial equality. This song was meant to be a beacon of hope. The rendition you will hear today is influenced by the King Singers' performance of Blackbird. You will hear a light and cheerful take on this powerful song of hope. Please enjoy Blackbird. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. Singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see. All your life, you were only waiting for this moment to be free. Singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life,
you were only waiting for this moment to arise.
You were only waiting for this moment to arise. You were only waiting for this moment to arise.
Hi, my name is Mary Denny, and I will be introducing this next piece from the University Chorus, Famine Song, originally written by American vocal quartet Vita and arranged by Matthew Culloton. This song was written in response to the Sudanese Civil War happening in the 1980s and was dedicated to the women living there who continued to raise their children despite the resulting famine and to continue their tradition of weaving colorful, elaborate baskets. This song goes out to them. Without further ado, here's Famine Song.
Hum, hum,
is my spirit, is my soul, please free my hands from this barren sore. Is my mother, is my child, earth and sky be reconciled.
Is my spirit, is my soul. Hi, I'm Haley Kading, and our next piece is a fun, contemporary, septet arrangement of And So It Goes by the popular recording artist Billy Joel. This song expresses Joel's feelings toward a relationship that he fears won't last. Our rendition will feature soloists Matthew Miramontes and Seth Nevis. I hope you enjoy our performance.
In every heart there is a room, a sanctuary safe and strong, to heal the wounds from lovers past, until a new one comes along. I spoke to
Susan Estrada. Our next selection is By and By, arranged by Dr. Marvin Curtis, presented by the University Chorus, featuring Elise Cody as soloist. The arrangement that you will hear shortly features a text of a traditional spiritual. We hope that you enjoy our performance of By and By.
By and by, ooh, by and by,
Hello, my name is Rose Dixon. This next piece, performed by the Pacific Singers, is Stacey V. Gibbs' a cappella arrangement of the African American spiritual Witness. Throughout this piece, the soloists ask, "Who will be a witness for my Lord?" against the syncopated chords of the choir, while also telling anecdotes from the Bible, including those of Nicodemus and Samson. We hope you enjoy our performance, featuring solos from Philo Abid and Madeline Renesis.
Who'll be a witness for my Lord? Who'll be a witness for my Lord? Who'll be a witness for my Lord? My soul is a witness for my Lord.
Be wise,
be prepared.
Piece brought to you by University Chorus is called It Takes a Village by Joan Skzymko. The text is adapted from the West African adage, it takes a whole village to raise a child, meaning that each individual within a child's community plays a part in their upbringing and development. Listen closely as each individual voice part plays a role in the formation of a much larger sound. Although we may be apart, we are united together in this song. Please enjoy It Takes a Village.
One child. Hi, my name is Nicole Ikeda. This piece was arranged by Dr. Che as a birthday song for UOP's 23rd president, Dr. Don DeRosa. Listen as the sweet melody of our alma mater, Pacific Hail, gives way to a multitude of lively happy birthday messages. Soloists Philo Abid and Madeline Reneses are joined by June Lee on piano, Arturo Garcia on alto saxophone, Aaron Leonard on bass and percussion, and the Pacific Singers. Please enjoy Pacific Hail Happy Birthday.
We wanna shout to you.